Pressure. Dear students, in a common spoken language, we consider pressure and force alike. But these are completely different quantities. Let's understand this with an example. Here is Aram. Aram is hungry. His mother gave him one apple and asked him to cut it. Aram searched his home and find these tools to cut the apple. Can you suggest him a right tool to cut the apple? Within fraction of seconds, you will say a knife. Absolutely right. Aram takes the knife, apply force on it and make two pieces. Can you tell me what would have happened if instead of knife, he had taken a metallic strip? Even if he apply equal force, still he would not be able to cut the apple in pieces. Here the magic happens. Dear students, the strip have larger cross-sectional area and so it apply force over a larger area of apple. Area being larger, the value of force divided by area comes out to be small, which is insufficient to make cut in apple. However, in case of sharp-edged knife, the cross-sectional area is very small. And so, if we apply equal amount of force over knife, the resulting force divided by area on apple is larger. As a result, apple undergo a cut. Considering this fact, we define the term pressure as the force divided by area on which force is acting or force per unit area applied on a body. That is, pressure is equals to force by area on which it is acting. Another example is pushing the iron nail in the wooden block. If the end of iron nail is not sharp, that is, blunt, then the area of cross-section is larger, due to which pressure applied on wooden block is smaller. Hence, it is difficult to push the iron nail. However, if iron nail have sharp end, then the pressure will be higher. And so, you can imagine how easy it would be to push the iron nail. You can find many daily life examples which are application of pressure. Porters put cloth on their head so as to increase the area over which load is to be placed. Doing so, they are able to spread the force of load on their head over a wide area. Due to this, pressure is reduced and so they carry load easily. In this video, we discussed on pressure exerted by solids. There are interesting facts about pressure exerted by liquids and gases that we will be learning in upcoming videos.